coming to you live from Stairway to Heaven Arena in beautiful downtown Purgatory. And it's a long way to the top if you want to rock and roll.
Hey, who just turned you into some generic classic rock DJ dipshit? That's the best you can come up with for an intro? How about a nice simple, here's the fucking kickoff?
Today's matchup is going to be complete mayhem. The teams are taking the field. The Snuffle Thrills take on the Full Metal Mayhem. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hi again, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here, along with the only guy to ever get cut from the league for testing positive for not taking enough steroids or mutant growth hormones, Brickhead Mulligan.
Hey, there was a reason for that. I had to quit taking steroids. My nutsack was shrinking, and I sprouted this mini-me on my shoulder. Pricks Jr., freak me out.
You're a pussy.
Will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
And he catches it for 6 yards. Good mitts on that play, Bricks. His fingers are like a bunch of sausages. Third and 4. And it's first and 10. And the cornerback is down.
Zoom in on his face. I want to see if the little bastard's crying.
Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this.
Hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse. For it. This could get uglier than the baby resulting from an orcish family reunion.
Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! And here comes the extra point attempt. Defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. We When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked out? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten. First and ten. And he's off to the races.
Goal!
If you ever do that again, Bricks, I'll shoot you in the head.
But people like it.
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. First and ten. He might have managed to dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, you know, mostly coffee. Tastes better, like Eskimos burying salmon heads. Kimchi. Fermented anything really tastes good.
Oh, man, what a throw. That sonic blast just cleared the field for the receiver. What a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and ten. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way.
Nobody can touch you with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about?
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. And it's first and ten. He's got his beast boost working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. And it's first and ten. Second down in a mile. It's a 6-yard gain. Third down and the punter is warming up. guys take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and 10.
I ate a piece of licorice once and got a shot like that.
It wasn't licorice, you idiot. It was the frayed cords of the leaf blower.
Well, it was a red cord and it looked like licorice. The point is, I forgot my point.
Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner.
When I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving.
And so at the end of one, we're all tied up. We'll be right back. And it's first and 10.
I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too. Second down and 10.
Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Rick.
I know, I hate those zebra men.
They're back up here on first, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever. That's a big gain run on that. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. And they needed that big run right there, Bricks.
They sure fucking did, Grim. They sure fucking did.
Third down and long. And he just nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown.
Yeah.
comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Hit. And it's first and ten. And they call a ginormous dirty trick.
He's so big that the last time he saw
he should apply for the Mutant Volleyball League.
Hey, don't give the fans any ideas. The commish already spends all day on Twitter shooting down rumors. Second down and ten. The quarterback passes the ball and rebounds back.
He can't get rid of it. It's like me and these crabs, Grim.
Yep, the defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick, and the QB is in a heap of trouble now.
Oh, yeah.
Third down and forever. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he put all of his foot into that one. And he snags. He refuses to go down. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
Cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. And it's first and ten. Gets the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. First and eight to go. And the defense spiked the offensive water with Strawberry Fields. And now they can taste sound, but can't remember what the concept of time is.
Sounds like you every day.
And they just popped his eyes into the back of his head. That quarterback can be hurting or dead. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. And the defense gave up a lot of yards on that pass play. They'll need to regroup quickly. Third down and eight.
Hot one, hot two.
And he snags it for six. Touchdown! Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. And it's first and ten. I I hope you covered your ears, Briggs, because that was a... He could go all the way! And here comes the extra point attempt. Right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and 10. Now the QB is dinking and dunking the defense to sleep. 1 yard on that pass. Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. Second down and 9. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
3rd and 4. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit. The quarterback just used his final timeout. Let's see what they come up with on the next play. And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And he throws that one to the sidelines. The drive was stalled, and here comes the field goal attempt. Right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck off. That was just a one-time thing.
And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Well, the third quarter coming up. Bricks, this game has been a hot mess so far.
Yeah, kind of like the morning after eating hot chicken wings. It's a hot mess on the exit ramp, if you know what I mean.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Bricks. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. And it's 1st and 10. Butterfingers, he should have had that one. Second down and 10.
Murphy Brown!
What?
I mean, first down!
What the hell was that?
I honestly don't know, Grim.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And that'll be second down and four. Third down and five. The quarterback is getting mauled out there. And it looks like the offense is desperate for a first down. The offense is pretty much unstoppable when they use their beast boost injection. Close your eyes, Bricks. This is going to get ugly fast. He broke free and has open field in front of him. The 20. He's at the 10. I can't believe the defense didn't stop the run. Or maybe they just secretly wanted four more shots at the QB. That's probably more like it. First down and five. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
I like this. They're going for two. And they run it in for 2 points. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and 10. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner.
QB, I'd be pissed.
Third down and never gonna happen. And they went to the air and came up big. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Quick pass, picks up maybe 2 yards. And that'll be second and 8 to go. Oh, and he just turned ginormous. Look out! That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. And then to first down from a great catch.
It's not murder if they have it coming, right? Take the hint. Do something about that ref, you pussies.
First down and long, and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down and a mile. The way you do it. Eat up chunks of yards with pinpoint passing. Second down in a mile. The ground game should be their bread and butter. A gain of 8 right there.
Hey, anyone seen that Korean kid yet with my barbecue?
Last time I ordered Korean, I got Kim Jong-il.
Throw, good catch, but not quite good enough at 9 yards. Ballsy? Stupid, maybe? I guess we'll decide after we see how this goes. But probably stupid. Kaboom! And the quarterback unleashes a son.
He scores!
Some would argue that demons don't have a place in this league, but with moves like that, I have to disagree.
You're just saying that because he ripped your face off and used it for bookbinding.
I don't see how that's not a valid reason. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good. Kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. He picks up 9 yards on that catch. That'll bring up second and 1. Wow! The quarterback just threw a sonic blast to his receiver. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. And it's first and 10. It's a pass and catch for a new game.
And how is it a pass?
That's the end of 3, and it's anyone's game. Hang on tight. The fourth quarter is about to begin. Second down and 10. An old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And it's first and 10. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown. Now, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Straight through the uprights. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. And it's first and 10. Oh, and they just deflated the quarterback's balls right there. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. The defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick. The quarterback can't dump it.
And now they're going to dump his ass.
Ooh, that hit's going to shave a few days off his life. Third down, and the punter is warming up.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. The return man catches the... Oh, nice hit! And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. And they just smacked that one back in his face. Third down and, well, good luck. Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
I had a dog named Snags. He got...
That, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. And it's first and 10. Up a two. And that'll be second and 8 to go. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor. Finish him.
Third down and 5. And they line up for the extra point. It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
first and 10. Ah, the strawberry field's dirty trick. As my mentor Hunter used to say, I don't advocate drugs, alcohol, narcotics, or insulin. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made into dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. First and 10.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
First time out under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
Second down and 7. And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
Third down and long. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my offseason.
And that's it. That's the last time out. It's score or die from here out. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill.
Hot two. Eight.
Perfect pass and a score. He could probably be a better dancer if he went to dance class, but as you can see, he doesn't have the stomach for it. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga, and they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast.
Why would they do that?
Oh, man, he reels.
And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. The timeout is called by the quarterback. They have 1 left. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. Oh, big catch! Big run! Big touchdown!
Eh, big deal. Mr. Meat for Brain ran with a ball and didn't fall down.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
gave us just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. It's first and 10. No one was open downfield, so the QB threw the ball away. Throw up the horns and throw up the W. Full Metal Mayhem win. That was one hell of a slugfest. That was worth the price of admission, right, guys?
Well, I pay for admission. I expect girls dancing on a pole or something.
Girls win. How about a lap dance?
You don't even have a lap, you little freakazoid.
Call me.
Let's see what the MVP has to say about today's outcome. Once again, the folks at EvilSN thank our viewing audience and the Newton Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it.